Hi guys, Sister Nadine. I have another lesson for you. I hope you're excited. The name of our lesson is, What Did I Do? It's found in Genesis chapter 4, verses 1 through 26. And we're going to have our fun time for you know what. So I hope you're ready to get your wigglies out.
Jesus loves the little ones like me. Jesus loves the little ones like me. Little ones like me, sat upon his knee. Jesus loves the little ones like me.
Little ones like you. He loves them through and through. Jesus loves a little.
enjoy those songs? Well, I did. I got my wigglies out. So now it's time to talk to God. I need everybody to close their eyes and pay attention and remember that when we're praying, we want to be respectful. So we want to let God know how we feel, and we want him to know that we care about talking to him. Dear God and Heavenly Father, thank you for another opportunity to learn more about you and your word. Help the children to understand what punishment and correction are for. Help them to accept the corrections that are necessary to help them learn. Help each child to know that you love them and want them to always do what is right. Help each child to learn from their mistakes so they won't have to receive correction again. In Jesus' name, amen. Our lesson this week, the application is, I must understand that God corrects me because he loves me. Amen. So our story continues. If you remember last week, we found out what happened when Adam and Eve sinned and God sent them out of the garden. In Genesis chapter 4, we find out what happens next. After Adam and Eve were told to leave the Garden of Eden, they found a place to live where they could grow crops and raise animals, and they had children. The name of one son was Cain, and the name of the other son was Abel. When the brothers grew up, Cain became a farmer who grew crops and worked in the fields. Abel was a shepherd and he took care of sheep. In those days, people showed their love and devotion to God by bringing gifts and laying them on a platform called an altar. Cain brought some vegetables that he had grown and placed them on the altar. But Abel's heart was different from Cain's. He did not place just anything on the altar. Abel had faith, and he placed the very best of his lambs and put that lamb on the altar. God was pleased with the offering that Abel made. Why do you think that was? Perhaps it was because God saw that Abel loved him much, much, much more, and that he wanted to give his very best. God was not pleased with Cain's offering. When Cain saw that God was more pleased with Abel, he became very angry. God saw how angry Cain was and said, "Cain, why are you so angry? If you do right, I will accept you. I will accept your offering. But if you do not do right, you will sin." God knew that if Cain did not stop being angry and jealous, he would do something terribly wrong. When he heard this, Cain should have stopped and told God he was sorry. But he was so angry, he did not think about doing good things. He did not control his anger, but only thought about how God had approved of Abel more than him. He was jealous of Abel. Cain did not control his anger and jealousy. He became more and more angry, that all of his anger just boiled up inside him.
Cain said to his brother Abel, "Let's go out in the field." And while they were out in the field, Cain attacked Abel and killed him. When God came to Cain, he asked, "Where is your brother Abel?" Cain answered, "Am I my brother's keeper? Is it my job to keep track of him all the time?" Cain killed his brother when he thought that no one was watching. But we know that God sees and knows everything that happens. God knew what Cain had done, and he knew that Cain must be punished. Your brother's blood is still on the ground. Your punishment is that nothing you plant will grow in the ground will grow. You will just wander around the earth finding food wherever you can. Cain was upset by this. "My punishment is more than I can bear," said Cain. "I will wander around, and whoever finds me will kill me." So God put a special mark on Cain so that anyone seeing the mark would know not to kill him. And then Cain went away from his family and his home. All right, guys. Wow. Doesn't sound like Cain made good choices, did it? So what did you guys learn? What were the names of Adam and Eve's first sons mentioned in the Bible? Did you say Cain and Abel? What were Cain and Abel's jobs? Did you say Cain was a farmer and Abel was a shepherd? What does it mean to give God an offering? Did you say to give God something valuable, to honor him? What did Abel offer God? Did you say his very best lamb? What did Cain offer to God? Did you say some of the vegetables from his crops? What did Cain do to Abel when God liked Abel's offering better? Did you say he killed Abel? What was Cain's punishment? Did you say he had to leave his family and wander around the rest of his life? So how did you guys do? Did you get most of the questions right? Were you paying attention? Well, I hope so, because God wants us to pay attention. So we have an activity that goes along with the lesson. It's called Close to God, and it's an example lesson, parents, so you can print it from the PDF. We have paper chain people that kids need to color. After they write on one of the figures, me, and on the other figure, God. Then you want to cut that chain and explain what happens when we sin and we continue to sin against God. What that means is that our fellowship with God is broken. Now, the next part of this object lesson is to take the figures back together, parents, to show that when we are corrected by God and we ask God to forgive us and we stop doing the bad things we know are wrong, we can be close to God. And that's really all God wants from us. He wants us to, when we make a mistake, to come to him and ask him to forgive us, and then he will. And then we can be close to him. And again, this is our Way of Salvation poster, and this is our quarterly poster that talks about how to be saved. And this is the most important thing that you can ever do. First, you have to tell God that you're a sinner and that you need him. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God, Romans 3:23. Then you have to believe that Jesus died for your sins and rose again from the dead. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. Acts 16:31. And then you need to ask Jesus to save you. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved, Romans 10:13. And that is a promise from God that you, once you do that, God will save you, and you can never, ever, 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 ever do anything to lose that. So we have an activity that goes with our lesson today. It's called Sinful Sam. Parents, this is also included in the PDFs. Kids, you need to find the word sin in the picture, and you need to color this picture and think of ways that Sam could have sinned. What kinds of things could Sam have done to sin? Our scripture today is found in Proverbs 3:12, and it is also an activity, parents, and you can print that out. So you can color the word phrases and then cut slits in the proverb paper. And then I want you to put them in order and practice saying that memory verse. How many times? Did you say 5 times? And it's not a very long scripture, so I bet you can say it. Whom the Lord loveth, he correcteth. Proverbs 3:12. Good job. I hope you did it. And then we do have a home activity. And it's, I want you to think about 3 things that got you in trouble, that your parents had to punish you or correct you. Maybe they put you on timeout, or maybe they took away a special privilege. You know, God wants you to remember that they correct you. He and their parents correct you because they love you and they care about you, and they don't want you to make the same mistakes. So I want you to think about the things, why you got corrected, and remember that if you don't do those things, then you won't get in trouble. And that's what God wants us to remember. When we are obedient and we do what he wants, he forgives us. Well, guys, that's our lesson for this week. I hope you have a good week, and I can't wait to see you. Remember, I love you, but more importantly, Jesus loves you. So have a great day, and remember to listen and obey your parents so you don't have to get corrected or punished. Okay, now, love you. Bye.